Dear students, today we shall discuss about the diction and style mentioned and described by Aristotle in his famous critic book, The Poetics. This is the chapter number 20 to 22. These three chapters are mainly concerned with the diction and style of a tragedy of a play that a poet should use or follow. So the certain things have been analyzed and have been said by Aristotle for the poet to keep in his mind, and how he can make his plays beautiful and readable using certain dictions and styles. Because we have already read in previous chapter that he talked about the thought in a tragedy, and thought can be expressed only through the diction, only through the speeches that are spoken or said by the characters. So whatever the character speaks, whatever the language they use, whatever the words they use are very much important, and they express the thought of the tragedy. And those words are in fact the vehicle to create the catharsis in a tragedy, to create the pity and fear, our emotions. So it is the words which are spoken by the characters in fact creates our pity and fear, our emotions. So let's now analyze or discuss the diction and style how Aristotle has described. Aristotle deals with diction of tragedy in detail in these three chapters. Most of it is highly technical. So diction is highly technical. It is based exclusively on Greek grammar, syntax and usage. Because diction means language, diction means the words, diction means the speeches of the words of the speeches. And therefore it is the grammar, it is the syntax, it is the usage, ki how they are used. So basically it is a discussion on Greek grammar, syntax and usage. So definitely it is highly technical. Moreover, the topic is not the part of criticism, but it is of grammar. So diction and style is not the part of criticism of poetry, but it is a part of grammar. How the grammar, how the words, how the syntax, the choice of the syntax, choice of the structure, choice of the usage that has been used by the poet, that is important. So we will have only significant points of Aristotle's discussion. What are these significant points? He says that diction is the choice and arrangement of words and images in a literary composition. That is what I have spoken. A poet's choice, and then the arrangement of the words. Arrangement of the words means the grammar, the usage that he uses in a literary composition, in a literary work, that is the play, that is the tragedy, that is the drama. So he says that the words a poet uses may be divided into six kinds. So according to Aristotle, we have six types of the words which a poet can use in a tragedy. So which are they? Number one, those words which are current in ordinary speech. So the current words, the words which are used in ordinary speech, we can also call them colloquial words. That is, which are used in daily speech. So the poet can use the words which are current in fashion, which are current in our ordinary speech. The second type of the words that a poet can use, that is foreign terms, which are imported from other languages, that is, which are taken from the other languages. So a dramatist who is writing in a Greek may borrow the words from the Latin, may take the words from Latin, may take the words from other literature, other languages, just like if you write in English, or we have many writings in English literature, and there the many poets and the writers, they have taken the words from the French, they have taken the words from the Greek, they have taken the words from the German and other languages. So a dramatist can use the foreign words, foreign terms, which may be from the dialect. So the dialect words can also be used. So dialect is also a language which is spoken in a certain limited area. So just like we have in our Rajasthan, we use Hindi. Basically our language is Hindi, but we have so many dialects. Then we have Rajasthani. In Rajasthani we have so many dialects. If you go to the Mewar regions, you will have the different dialects. If you go to the Jodhpur region, you will get the different dialect. If you go to the Jaipur region, you have the different dialect. And if you go to the Bikaner or Jhunjhunu region, you will get the different dialects. Although there are many similarities, even then they are considered the different dialects of our language. So in the same way, a poet or a dramatist can use the dialects. Here, for example, fi or inui. These are the dialectical words. These are not the just like the words of the Greek language. But here poet gives the example that these are the foreign words which can also be used. So two types of words he has described. Then the third type of the words are those which are metaphorical. So a poet can use and always use or must use metaphorical, because without metaphorical, the poetry doesn't exist. The poetry requires the metaphorical language, metaphorical words, just like cold-blooded. So this is the phrase, cold-blooded. See, it is a metaphorical language. Similes, metaphors, these are used in a drama. You know very well, and you have so many examples in your poetry as well as in plays. Then the fourth kinds of words are ornamental periphrases. They are the ornamental. They are the fashionable. They are the decorative words, decorative phrases. Just like beloved of 18th century poet. So this is ornamental phrase which is used for the persons who love the 18th century poets. So the beloved of 18th century poet. In the same way, we also call that Udaipur is the Kashmir of Rajasthan. So Kashmir of Rajasthan, this is the ornamental. We say Kalidas is the Shakespeare of India. Shakespeare of India, this is the ornamental. And in this way, a poet can can make his language, his uses very lovely and attractive. Then Aristotle says that the fifth kind of the words which a poet can use or use generally uses, which are the new coinage. That is, you make the new coin, new words, coining or combining them together. Two words are there and you combine them and make the new word. Though there are so many coin words available in language, but a poet sometimes uses his own intellect, own mind, and he combined two words together in such a way that they create some kind of greater effect, some kind of better effect in the poetry. We have so many words. If you go any poem, if you go with any play, you will find such words. Then the sixth kinds of the words that here Aristotle is describing or discussing, that is the forms. Though they are not entirely invented, but modified by lengthening as in the case of fairy and shortening as in so on, course in copies. That is, you, a poet can change the form of the words, form of the diction. Just making it an adjective, making it an verb, making it an adverb, noun, etc. So, for example, he can give the length to the word, that is making it lengthy, as well as he can also short that word. So today, if you see, we have if you go with the language of mobile or WhatsApp writing or today's writing, you will find so many examples of shortening the words. We write in short. If you want to write the word, just like text, then you write TXT. You remove the E from there. In the same way, so many words are there. You use in such a way, in a short form. Just like if you want to write short, some people write only SHRT or SRT, short. So this is the way that a poet can also use. So here are the examples. Sovan. Sovan is for the sovan. Sovan, SOVERIGN. And he uses it as SOVRAN. Cause, that is for corpse. So for the corpse, he uses only the cause. So we have many examples in our language, and here Aristotle also approves such words in poetry. So these were the six kinds of the words that Aristotle is defining a poet can use in his poetry or in a drama, in a tragedy. And then he tells us something about the style. And what is the style of poet's style? That is, it should fulfill two conditions. There are two important conditions of all the poet's style, we can say. What he says? That it must be clear. So the poet's style must be clear. It must not be mean. So two things that a poet should adopt for his style of using the words. So if it uses only current words, so six types of the words he has mentioned, then he says that the style must be clear, the style must not be mean. So he says ki if a poet uses only current words, it's okay. Then it is clear, no doubt. It is clear. It will be clear. But it will be mean. It will not be a good style if you use only the one type of word, that is the current words. As Wordsworth often has done so. In Wordsworth poetry, we find the current words. Though they are very clear, but they are not we can say, having the importance or significance. Then, if a poet uses only strange words, if he uses only strange words, it means it will not be clear. It will be not mean, but either obscure or jargon. So it will be clear, but it will not be mean. बिल्कुल कम मतलब एक तरह से तुच्छ या नीचे के शब्द नहीं होंगे स्ट्रेंज वर्ड्स, बट द स्ट्रेंज वर्ड्स क्रिएट द डिफिकल्टी, क्रिएट द ऑब्सक्योरिटी टू अंडरस्टैंड देम. सो अ पोइट शुड नॉट कंप्लीटली यूज द स्ट्रेंज वर्ड्स इन हिज पोइट्री. अ पोइट शुड नॉट यूज ओनली द करेंट वर्ड्स इन हिज राइटिंग. Then he says, accordingly, modified words, variant forms are useful as being neither mean nor obscure. So according to Aristotle, modified words should be there. They are neither mean, they are neither obscure. They are not difficult to understand. So a poet should modify the words. A poet should use those words according to his necessity, according to his readers. Then he says, compounded words, he thinks, are the best for the dithyamb, that is full dress, lyric or ode. For the ode, for the lyric, the compounded words are the best one Aristotle recommends for. Then he says, rare words shoot epic. For the epic, a poet must use the rare words, which are not common words, which are not frequently used, but they are used rarely. So that words should be included, used by the epic writer, epic poet. Then he says that whereas metaphorical diction is best suited to the iambic verse of drama. So Aristotle, advocates, he recommends metaphorical diction, that only best suits the verse of drama, iambic verse of drama. So for a drama, metaphorical language is must, and that should be used by a poet. And for this is the meter, which is closest to the prose of ordinary life, as befits an imitation of that life. So the meter, iambic verse, that has the meter. According to that meter, the meter requires the metaphorical diction only. So a poetical diction, which is mainly metaphorical, can similarly keep closes to the language of ordinary life. So the poetic diction, so far is concerned, he recommends the metaphorical language, which is very much close to the ordinary life, ordinary people, and that must be used in a drama. So the gift of metaphor is the greatest of all, and this alone cannot be thought, but is a mark of natural genius. So this is the केवल विचारों से नहीं आ सकती. दिस इज इट ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्स द नेचुरल जीनियस ऑफ द पोइट. इफ द पोइट इज जीनियस, ओनली देन ही कैन यूज द मेटाफोरिकल लैंग्वेज. सो इट इम्प्लाइज एन इनबॉर्न आई फॉर लाइकनेस. सो मेटाफोरिकल, दैट इज द कंपैरिजन वी हैव द मेटाफर्स, दैट इज द मेटाफोरिकल लैंग्वेज. टू द फार रीचिंग ट्रूथ ऑफ दिस लास्ट स्टेटमेंट, disguised as usual in the simple, casual language of Aristotle, criticism usually does little justice. So criticism normally cannot do the justice. It does the little justice. So criticism is another thing and writing poetry is another thing. So criticism is always in a balance. It cannot give the justice to anything. So it is not fully realized how much the art of poetry consists in the somewhat childish pleasure. So you cannot judge that this art or this play or this drama is full of what childish pleasure is there, or that one can realize it, there is childish pleasure or the better pleasure or the another kind of the pleasure. So you cannot justify. So criticism is always here Aristotle in fact refutes the criticism. So his treatment of metaphor is clear, concise and inspired. So basically a dramatist, a poet should use the metaphorical language in his poetry. That is the natural genius of the poet. That is the poetic diction, and which can influence and impress the readers as well. So this is what we have by Aristotle about the diction and style of a tragedy, of a poetic creation or the poetry. So thank you very much, dear students, and in one or two further lectures we would be finishing this poetics, and then we will start some another writer of this paper that has been prescribed for your study. So till then, thank you very much. See you.